It is officially NBA draft eve, and we have a huge blockbuster trade to discuss. We'll talk about how it impacts the Sixers. Also, will Daryl Morey ever trade Tobias Harris? Will he get the Sixers involved in the draft tomorrow? We'll break all that down and more here on Philly Take with RB. Perfect. What is going on, everybody? RB here. Welcome into the show. Like always, hit the like button if you enjoy the content. Be sure to subscribe. Also, ring that bell down below. That way you don't miss any of the coverage. We have a lot to get into, a lot of draft intel today, but most importantly, a huge move that impacts the Sixers, the Eastern Conference as a whole. We'll talk about whether it was a good or bad deal and what it could lead to. Real quick, a poll question I put out today on YouTube community. Let me know down below in the comments section. Should the Philadelphia 76ers be interested in trading for Paul George? Reports came out last night that the Clippers may be gauging his trade value. Could it even be realistic? Let me know your thoughts on that down below. Before we get into all of our thoughts and our extended breakdown here of everything going on today, as you know, it's going to be a hectic 24 hours. Quick shout out to our sponsor of today's video, Mantis Sleep. You guys got to check out the Mantis Sleep Mask Pro. Let me tell you something, man. You're going to need your energy tomorrow, and you're going to need your sleep tonight in order to do so. And you got to check out the Mantis Sleep Mask Pro. My mind's always wandering at night. I can't sleep. I can't rest. But ever since I started using this product, man, my sleep has gone up 10, 20, 30%. This thing is true 100% blackout for deep sleep. C-shaped eye cups for unbeatable side sleep comfort. Very lightweight. You just throw it over the head. You can lay on your back, your side, stomach, whatever. This thing will help take your sleep to the next level. No pressure at all on the eyelashes or eyelids. Like I said, very lightweight, very breathable product. Doesn't make your eyes sweat or anything like that. They got the Mantis Sleep Cool Mask, the Steam Mask, Pro Mask, Aroma Mask. Overall, all the insomniacs out there need to give this thing a chance because honestly, it'll help you black everything out, get rid of all the distractions, and really just take your sleep to the next level. So go check out the Mantis Sleep Mask Pro. Click the link down below in the description. Go to mantisleep.com. Use promo code PhillyTake to get 10% off of your order. All right, let's get into all this, man, because what a day has it been. And I want to start off with an article that Kyle Newbeck put out last night. I summed up the main points in this article. We talked a few days ago about Newbeck's Tobias Harris trade article, what that could mean for draft night, but he put out a huge piece, and shout out to Kyle, always doing a great job. I just summed up the best points here from the article and just things to keep in the back of your head as we enter draft night tomorrow. Daryl Morey, for one, is trying to purchase a second round pick. Number two, it looks increasingly likely, this is words from Kyle Newbeck, that James Harden will return to the Sixers on a, quote, team-friendly deal. That is a good thing to hear, because if he does come back, as I've said all along, it has to be most likely, I don't know, a two-year deal with a player option, maybe three-year, but he needs to keep the team interest in mind. You may say, oh, that's not fair. He took a pay cut last year. I get it, but at the end of the day, the Sixers are a business. They're trying to win, and giving James Harden a max contract will just not help that in the short or long term. So definitely good to hear that from Kyle Newbeck. He has the inside sources. I do not. Number three on the list, he says Paul Reed is likely to stay. George Niang and Jalen McDaniels are in wait and see mode. This kind of reflects what we've heard the last week or so. So hopefully they can re-sign Paul Reed, and we'll see what happens with a couple other free agents. Obviously, you traded Thibault. You traded a pick to get McDaniels from the jump. They said they wanted to re-sign McDaniels, so hopefully they can make that happen. And lastly, the Sixers believe they'll have, quote, multiple windows to trade Tobias this offseason. So what does this mean? I mean, it kind of leads me back towards the side of my original thought that I don't think Tobias is going to get moved on draft night because, you know, the Sixers think they have free agency, the draft, et cetera, where, you know, teams will be able to swoop in, get hungry. But as we mentioned a couple days ago, if they wait until after July 1st, they are going to take a little bit of a penalty in terms of, you know, what they're able to do. Not really a penalty, but just have more restriction on what they're able to do, how they're able to move them, and what they're able to bring back. So it's going to be, you know, get real interesting. Will Daryl Morey come out of nowhere and make a trade tomorrow? He traded Horford on draft night, traded Danny Green. You never know. Maybe he comes out and swoops in some players from another team for Tobias Harris. I don't know. Another piece of Sixers news today that dropped. Montrezl Harrell, per Chris Haynes, declining his $2.7 million player option for this upcoming season, as we all expected, and will become an unrestricted free agent. So, Trez, peace out, man. Unfortunately, it couldn't work in Philly. I was really excited about the Trez signing. I thought he was going to be a dog on this team. I was excited, you know, for him to be under his old coach, Doc Rivers. And I think he got benched, what, like 20 games into the year and never came back. And didn't do anything, really. I forgot he was on the team at one point. You know, he made some subliminal tweets. I think that was probably his biggest accomplishment other than the ladder gate. I mean, that was the highlight of his season. So good luck to Montrezl Harrell wherever he lands. I mean, a couple years ago, or maybe like what, 3-4 years ago, he was a sixth man of the year. So we'll see how that works. In other news around the league, and we'll talk about how this impacts the Sixers, but the Denver Nuggets have traded a 2024 first round pick and a 2023 40th overall pick for this draft to the Pacers and acquired two picks, late first round, early second round. Why did I put this up here as a piece of news? The Nuggets won the championship and they're getting better. They just acquired two picks. They're going to go out, make things happen. They made a trade during the finals. You can never be content. These teams are out here making moves. They just won the championship. What are they worried about? They have one of the best rosters in the league. Bruce Brown declined his player option. Who knows if he'll come back? The Denver Nuggets are continuing to upgrade. You can never be content. You have to always look for ways to get better. And that's exactly what they're doing. Daryl Morey, got to wake up. Got to wake up a little bit. Speaking, though, of Daryl Morey, a lot of Sixer fans are up in arms today because they're mad at Daryl because he hasn't done anything yet. And that brings me back to one thing I said last week. It's not going to be as easy as you think it is to trade Tobias Harris. You know, people, again, keep throwing out these crazy scenarios. Trade Toby for this and that and this. It's not realistic. I've been bringing up some ideas, but I always say it doesn't feel like it's going to happen. And now they say they have multiple windows. I don't know if they're going to trade Tobias this offseason. They might hold on to him till the deadline, till the team's real hungry to come in and get a piece like that. I don't know, man. At the end of the day, I think you have to move the contract. It's the only way the Sixers can get better. But Daryl Morey's out there, and I'm telling you his mindset right now, he likes to swing for the home runs. He likes to swing for the fence. He's looking for actual value or maybe a star that he could try to bring back. It's just going to be hard with that deal. Tobias would probably be more favorable to a team looking to take on cap space on an expiring deal like his contract. It's just, what can you get back? Daryl Morey's not going to trade Tobias Harris for Buddy Hield, most likely. Why? Because he doesn't view in his mind that Buddy Hield's going to help the Sixers this year, you know, put them over the top. That's my opinion of what Daryl Morey's mindset is. I think he's looking for a bigger name. I just don't know if he is going to find it. So we'll have to wait and see. But the big news that struck the NBA universe today out of nowhere, and maybe this is why the Sixers could make a deal. Kristaps Porzingis is headed to the Boston Celtics in a huge draft eve blockbuster. Porzingis to the Celtics. The Clippers receive Malcolm Brogdon, and the Wizards receive Gallinari, Marcus Morris, Amir Coffey, and the number 30 pick. Wizards obviously trying to stock up on draft picks. The Clippers, I don't know why they traded for Brogdon. I mean, he gets injured a lot, and you know, some Celtics fans were a little bit down on him. But the Celtics get Porzingis. And the funniest thing to me is I'm seeing all these Sixer fans go at Daryl Morey, but 2 days ago they were pissed off when everybody said, you know, let's look into Porzingis, right? He's going to get traded, maybe sign a 4 or 5 year deal. I said, I don't know if I would give him that contract, but now the Celtics get him and everybody's up in arms. Oh, Daryl Morey didn't do anything. Let's take it one day at a time. Deep breath, deep breath. Give the guy some time to make something happen. It's not as easy to trade Tobias as you think. However, what I will say, though, is that the Celtics made a really good trade here. They didn't really give up much. They came out of nowhere, and they got Porzingis. Now, does that really help the fit of their team with Brown, Tatum, Horford, Williams? To me, they kind of just need a ball handler that can take some pressure off of the two scorers. So was it a smart idea to get Porzingis? I don't know, but the guy's a unicorn. He had a fantastic year, and the Celtics, even though they were this close, once again got better. They've been this close for years, and every time they find a way to get better. So when you look at the Celtics or when you look at the Nuggets, my message to Daryl Morey is you have to make something happen. I'm not all up in arms saying, oh, you didn't make a trade today, so you should get fired. But other teams are making moves. Other teams are getting better. And I know you're handcuffed in a way, but there's no reason the Sixers couldn't have at least inquired about Porzingis. Porzingis what maybe wouldn't have been the best fit, but he would have been a decent fit in Philadelphia. I don't know, man. At the end of the day, it's just people want to see things happen. Like, they want to feel like there's progress. You got the coach. You're probably bringing Harden back, but you still have to make this team better around Embiid and Harden and Maxey. And guys got to develop and improve, but you know, just having Tobias on a roster makes you feel handcuffed. And speaking of which, here's a video of Daryl Morey earlier today, drinking a coffee, walking down the side of the street. What is he reading right now? What is he looking at? Is he on the phone with the GM or is he reading Twitter? I think he's reading Twitter right now. What do you guys think? What do you think? I don't know. The reason I started off the show asking about Paul George, as I mentioned, the Clippers are gauging his value. Could you ever see a way that the Sixers could bring PG-13 to Philadelphia? The answer is probably no. But if the Clippers are going in this direction, I don't really know what they're doing. But if they want to break up that tandem, that honestly, if we want to keep it 100, has been a failure with Paul George and Kawhi Leonard, would they ever be interested in bringing back Tobias Harris, who had his best year in LA and can, you know, still give you 20 a game, maybe has a bigger role on the Clippers? Who knows about Kawhi Leonard if they're going to get rid of him too? If they were to trade PG, then why not just go into full rebuild at that point, take on Tobias, let him expire, etc.? You know, I don't know. But if the Sixers could ever find a way to get involved in PG sweepstakes, I would do so for sure. I know he gets hurt, but the upside, the potential with Maxey and Embiid would be very, very high. And if they could stay healthy, I mean, I think they'd be a good tandem. Paul George would provide that consistent forward depth that you need, could be a scorer at all levels, can definitely be a lot more consistent than Tobias Harris. But here is PG's contract. One reason why other teams may be out on him: number one, he gets hurt a lot. And two, he's got a player option in 2024-25 for $49 million. So essentially, you're looking at, you know, $95 million almost wrapped up the next 2 years. So maybe a team doesn't want to commit, you know, to a 34-year-old, you know, paying him $49 million. Maybe that's a reason the Sixers could try to go out. And I know Daryl Morey likes the big names, but just something to keep your mind on for now. At the end of the day, it's draft day tomorrow. Will the Sixers trade for a second round pick? A lot of questions, need some answers. We will break it all down here on the show. Be sure to come out tomorrow night for the draft stream. Appreciate everybody tuning in. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And with that being said, I will catch you all on the next one. Peace.